Hi, I'm Dave, and welcome to the second Autocratik Broadcast. I've been a bit absent online recently, and there's a good reason for that. I've been on the other side of the planet. This is a bit of a shocker to everybody who knows me, because I'm not a traveller. I really don't travel. The flight over was not brilliant. It was very long, 12 hours to Kuala Lumpur, and then another 6 hours to Adelaide. I'm going to intersperse this video with a load of video clips that I shot while I was in Australia, along with a load of photos that I took. I know this looks a bit like, here's the slides, this is me on the beach, and this is me in a cafe, and this is me, this is what I had for breakfast, and this is the landscape, and there's another shot of the hotel. But I'm hoping this isn't quite as dull as that. So here we go, day one in Australia. Here we are in Adelaide. Adelaide's very cool. It's huge. We bought some stuff from a very cool anime manga shop called Shin Tokyo, which is in the Rundle Mall. That kind of sums up day one. And then after a few days in Adelaide, we boarded the Ghan, rather splendid and epically long train, which takes you from Adelaide up through the center of Australia on what was a 25 hour train journey. Never complain about the length of a train journey in the UK again.
It looks like the Orient Express.
It does, or the Hogwarts Express.
Hogwarts Express.
Hogwarts Express.
How cool.
Well, the Australian equivalent, which would be?
Something I can't pronounce, probably. Wallabra Wonga.
Wombat Express.
The Ghan was a gorgeous train. It's huge. It's like something from the end of From Russia With Love, where you have little sleeper cars and you go off and have your five-star meal in the dining car. And when you come back, the cabin staff have flipped all the seats over so that there are bunk beds and you have your own little shower and everything like that. Fantastic. I mean, how cool is that? This is like five-star living in the middle of the desert. So here we go with day four, and we're still on the train. It seems really strange sleeping on a train with proper beds and everything like that, especially with shower facilities and things. But the service here has been astoundingly good and the train is gorgeous. In the middle of the night, we seem to stop for about 2 hours, which was very odd because the actual motion of the train actually led to the weird drinks I had last night. So I actually woke up when we stopped, which we would have thought would have been the other way around. But it seems we stopped it in the middle of the night, in the middle of nowhere. But looking at the map, it looks like this morning we passed through a place called Mar very early on. Let's see if I can get the map on the screen. There it is, look. Marla. I thought it was quite funny really, because it meant that whereas Marla usually keeps us up in the middle of the night, our cat called Marla, we actually went to a place called Marla in the middle of the night as well. Weird. Up through the centre of Australia and we got off at Alice Springs. We spent a night in Alice Springs at a hotel called Lassiter's, which is probably famous for being used in Priscilla, Queen of the Desert. From Alice Springs, we were picked up by a rather excellent tour company called AAT Kings, who drove us another 300 kilometers over to the Red Center, which is a collection of hotels fairly close to Uluru, which used to be called Ayers Rock. From there, we had a number of trips out. We saw sunset at Uluru, and then the following day we did sunrise at Uluru. And we did a rather excellent sunset barbecue in the Uluru State Park. You have your meal out under the stars, and then they lead you out to a car park where the coaches are, but they turn all the lights off, and the nearest civilization, they were saying, is further away than the nearest satellite going overhead. So as you can imagine, absolutely zero light pollution. And we were lucky enough to have a very clear night, so you could actually see the belt of the Milky Way overhead. And the tour guide pointed off to a couple of clouds in the distance and pointed out that they weren't actually clouds, but two other galaxies that you could see with the naked eye, which is kind of phenomenal. This is day 6. Time. Tea break.